Hello everyone, I am Bob and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. In this design series episode, we're going to cover how to add Bitcoin heating to a house with an existing hydronic or hot water heating system. So with that, let's get started. Okay, in my first home heating with Bitcoin episode, I outlined the four different setups for heating your home with Bitcoin. And those are either using forced air or hydronic or hot water heating to heat your house, and either keeping your miners on all the time or only turning your miners on when heat is needed. And so in this episode, I'm going to cover this option, homes with hydronic or hot water heating and keeping your miners on all the time. Now, before I get started, I want to note that hydronic heating can get kind of complicated. I'm definitely not an HVAC or hydronic system expert. I've learned as much as I can from as many sources as I can find, but I'm still learning as I go here. And so before you do anything with your home heating system, you really should consult an expert. Treat everything presented here as just a starting idea or rough concept to start from. And if after watching this video, you really want to learn more, I highly suggest visiting the Caleffi website and YouTube channel. They have a ton of free information on how these systems work and how to design and build them. I've pulled most of the material presented here from those sources, and I have links below if you want to learn more. Now, when it comes to hydronic or hot water heating, there's a lot of variability in how these systems are configured. To do this right, you're going to have to really understand how your existing system works to make the best choice on how to integrate Bitcoin heating. Again, I'm not an expert, but I think the best way to look at these systems is to divide them into two groups: systems with buffer tanks and system without buffer tanks. Looking at systems without buffer tanks first, they are often fairly simple and straightforward. You have a boiler, a pump, and the radiators in your house. Now, you might think of just inserting a heat exchanger into the heating lines in front of the boiler. And although this might work, it's really not recommended. With this setup, fluid is always circulating through the boiler without the boiler running. And most boilers aren't designed to run this way. The pump control circuit would also have to be reworked to make sure that the pump is running for both the Bitcoin and boiler heating. And most importantly, if the boiler is turned on to provide backup heat for the house, that could be passed back through the heat exchanger into the miner cooling loop, which could overheat your miners. Instead, it is recommended to reroute the hydronic system to have two parallel fluid heating circuits. In this case, the fluid pump would be moved from the hot side to the cold side of the boiler, and an additional pump would be added to circulate the heat through the Bitcoin heat exchanger into the home heating circuit. Now, although this setup is a little more work and a little more expensive, there are a couple advantages here. First, the existing boiler and pump controls won't be changed. Everything can work as designed, including your existing thermostat setup, making for a solid backup to heat your house. Second, since the fluid loop going through the Bitcoin heat exchanger has its own pump, it can operate on its own control system independently of your existing boiler. It can take over heating of the house as a completely separate heating system using the existing hot water piping. And when the main boiler is turned on to heat the house, the pump in the Bitcoin powered loop can be turned off to prevent any heat from being transferred back into the Bitcoin mining loop. Now, the next configuration is one where the existing house heating loop is kept the same with the same pump, but then the existing boiler is rearranged to connect to this loop using a set of closely spaced T-fittings. The boiler would then have its own circulator pump, and the Bitcoin heat exchanger would also be connected this same way with its own pump. This setup uses something called hydronic separation, which is a topic I won't cover here, but what it means is that either the existing boiler or the Bitcoin heater can run alone or work together. The downside with this setup is that you'd have to buy two extra pumps and do some rewiring work to make sure the main circulator pump works regardless of which heater is operating. Again, you might want to talk to a hydronic system expert to find out the best way to add Bitcoin heating to your home. Now, the other big grouping of hydronic heating systems are those with a buffer tank. And a buffer tank is simply a tank of water used to absorb and store thermal energy. You can think of these as a big thermal battery. Now, there is a huge amount of variation in how buffer tanks can be used in a hydronic system. These tanks can be very large or very small, and could be part of a pressurized system or a separate tank open to ambient pressure. This generally makes these systems more complicated than systems without buffer tanks. However, although these systems are going to be a little more complex, systems with buffer tanks can be much better for Bitcoin heating, particularly when keeping your miners on all the time, since heat can be slowly stored up from a low-powered Bitcoin mining setup. Now, because of the huge amount of variation in these systems, I'm just going to give some examples of how these can be set up. Treat these ideas or concepts as a starting point. And as always, get a qualified expert to look things over before you start making any changes to your home heating system. And so the first example is just a slight change to that closely spaced T system I showed previously, with the small addition of adding a buffer tank along with the Bitcoin miner heat exchanger. If this is built right, you can generate a thermal convective flow between the heat exchanger and the buffer tank so that the fluid will automatically circulate, heating up the tank. Heat will slowly accumulate in the tank at a constant rate over time and can be stored until you use it later. Next up is a system with a boiler behind a buffer tank. This type of setup is built for small boiler sizes and homes with more extensive heat zoning. Adding Bitcoin heat here means just adding another parallel loop to the existing setup. The Bitcoin heater can continually supply heat to the buffer tank, and the boiler would just need to add backup heat when it's needed. If you're lucky enough to have this existing setup, adding Bitcoin heat can be an easy addition. There's no change needed to your existing thermostat or control system. You can just wire the Bitcoin loop pump to circulate water continuously, and your existing boiler will just run less often. The final system is one where the existing boiler is in front of the buffer tank. Now, to be honest, the only reason why you'd have this setup is if you already have a wood-fired or solar thermal generator already installed, so this is going to be a little less common. But with this setup, adding Bitcoin heating is really straightforward. Just add a loop to the buffer tank on the other side of the tank. Again, if designed correctly, you can get a thermal convective flow going, which will add heat to the tank without a pump, or a small circulator pump can be added if needed. Either way, heat is continuously built up into the tank and then used when needed. Now, for all of these systems, a brazed plate heat exchanger is used to connect the Bitcoin immersion system to the home heating system. This simple interface means there's not any difference between using a single loop or dual loop Bitcoin immersion mining setup. Both should work here. I've covered dual loop versus single loop systems in a previous episode, so if you are looking for more information on the advantages and disadvantages of single versus dual loop systems, that's a great place to start. Now, as a reminder, the goal in this video is to heat a home while keeping the miners always on, so we'll need a way to cool the miner cooling loop when the heat is not being used for home heating. And this is where hydronic heating setups make this really easy. In every one of these configurations, heat is transferred between the Bitcoin cooling loop and the home heating loop using a brazed plate heat exchanger. On the miner cooling loop side, all that is needed is to place this brazed plate heat exchanger before the dry cooler. When heat is needed by the home heating systems, the heat exchanger will pull heat from the Bitcoin miner loop. And when heat is not needed, the fluid will pass through the heat exchanger, staying at the same temperature. Either way, the Bitcoin cooling fluid will continue to the dry cooler and be completely cooled down before it returns to the miners. Now, one thing I've kind of glossed over is the specific sizes of the heat exchangers, pumps, piping, and other parts needed to make this work. And the reason why I can't give the exact sizes here is that each system is unique. You have to either do the calculations to figure this out or make some rough guesses and hope things work. In a previous episode, I walked through some high-level calculation methods, and the Caleffi information linked in the description below is a great source if you want to figure this out. However, if you're interested in making rough guesses and hoping things work, there's a few bits of information I can share. For the heat exchanger, going bigger than you need isn't going to hurt. For a 1 to 2 miner system, a 4-inch by 12-inch 20-plate heat exchanger should be big enough. For pipe size, going with 3/4-inch to 1-inch piping should work. And for pumps, a mid-level multi-speed pump like the Bell & Gossip NRF22 is a good place to start. Okay, so that's all I have for this episode. In the next few episodes, I'm going to continue covering how to heat your house with Bitcoin. I'll be covering the remaining options where you turn off your Bitcoin miners when you aren't using heat, and how to hook everything up to your existing thermostat. So with that, bye!